Good day, Grade 11 students. This is again Director RJ S. Olarve, and we're just going to continue our discussion regarding Earth Science, specifically First Quarter Module 3 and Video Tutorial Number 3. So last time, we talked about the different factors that enable Earth to support life. There, we talked about 8 factors that enable Earth to support life, and these are 1. Right distance from the sun, 2. Presence of an atmosphere, 3. Right amount of gravity, 4. The presence of magnetosphere, 5. The presence of molecular oxygen, 6. The presence of liquid water, 7. Generation of internal heat, and last is energy from lightning. And for the continuation of our discussion, for this video tutorial, we're going to have Earth's subsystems. So subsystems is also known as the Earth's spheres or Earth's systems. We're in here in this video tutorial, we're going to discover what are the different Earth subsystems, as well as the concept of a system, and also the interconnection or connection of the systems of the Earth to one another. And for the introduction, we're going to have the Earth as a system. So what does it mean? So it means that the Earth is subdivided into different spheres, or what we call systems or subsystems. And these spheres or subsystems interact with one another to achieve a common goal. And take note of this goal. That goal is to support the life on the planet Earth. Another thing is this relationship that connects the entire system, because there is this connection between the different spheres of the Earth. Because in order for them to attain and to achieve their common goal, which is to support the life on Earth, they need to really connect with one another. And that relationship that connects the entire system is known as the Earth system. And later on, we're going to have examples on how this specific sphere of the Earth is connected to another sphere of the Earth. And the question now is, what are the Earth's systems, or what are the different subsystems or spheres of the Earth? So generally, there are 4, and the first one is the hydrosphere. So hydrosphere is made up of all the water found on the Earth, such as on its surface, underground, and in the air. About 70% of the Earth is actually covered by liquid water, and that liquid water is known as the hydrosphere, and much of it is in the form of ocean water. And also, only 3% of Earth's water is fresh. 2/3 are in the form of ice, and the remaining 1/3 is present in streams, lakes, and groundwater. And examples are rivers, lakes, streams, oceans, groundwater, water vapor, clouds, and any form of precipitation. And there are 3 forms of precipitates. And what are these? So first one is the snow, second is the hail, and the third is rain. So we have here a picture showing the hydrosphere. So we have water, water, and water. So basically, hydrosphere is concerned with the different forms of water, such as in its gaseous state, liquid, or solid state. Next sphere is the geosphere. So geosphere is composed of rocks, minerals, and soil on the Earth. And examples are mountains, continents, ocean floor, sand in the desert, and bedrocks. Another thing is it also includes all the layers of the Earth. Actually, some of the references, they say that it is not actually the geosphere that is known as one of the spheres of the Earth, but instead it is the lithosphere. And right now, let us have the difference between the geosphere and lithosphere. So I have here a picture showing the difference between the geosphere and lithosphere. So geosphere, as mentioned, this includes all the layers of the Earth, while on the other hand, the lithosphere is just the crust plus the upper layer of the mantle. And also we have here the what we call asthenosphere, wherein this is a specialized layer in the mantle, wherein this is where we can find the magma. And by the way, there are 4 major layers of the Earth, such as the crust, which has 2 types, the continental and the oceanic. We also have the mantle, which is the thickest of all the layers. And we have the outer core, which is known to be liquid. And last is the solid inner core. And this figure 1-2 shows the different layers of the Earth. And we have here some pictures also showing the different geosphere. There we have examples of geosphere. Next sphere is the atmosphere. So atmosphere is the body of gas that envelops the planet Earth. And the air of the Earth has approximately 79% nitrogen and less than 21% oxygen. And the rest is carbon dioxide and other gaseous elements that surround the Earth. And also we have here the picture showing the different layers of the atmosphere. So we have the first layer, okay, so from the bottom we have the troposphere, wherein this is the layer of the atmosphere kung saan yun lang yung naaabot ng mga airplane, okay, ng paglipad or sa paglipad nila. And also we have the stratosphere, wherein this is the layer where we can find the ozone layer. And we have the mesosphere, wherein dito nangyayari yung shooting star. Okay, and we also have the thermosphere, wherein this regulates the temperature of the planet Earth. And last is the exosphere, wherein dito naman nakalocate yung mga satellites. Fourth major sphere is the biosphere. So biosphere is made up of all the living organisms on the planet. So living organisms, by the way, is categorized into two. First, we have the macroorganisms and the microorganisms. So when we say macroorganisms, you can see these organisms by just merely looking at them. So malalaki sila, hindi mo na kailangan gumamit ng microscope. While on the other hand, the microorganisms, so they cannot be seen by the naked eye. Instead, you need to use microscope in order for you to view them. Moreover, so biosphere includes all the living things, no exemption. So this includes the plants and the animals. And the biosphere is also known to be the set of all life forms on the planet Earth. In addition, biosphere also covers all the ecosystems, starting from the soil to the rainforests, from the mangroves to coral reefs, and from the plankton-rich ocean surface to the deep sea. So basically, all the life forms, their interaction with one another, this is under the biosphere. Next, for the majority of life on Earth, the base of the food chain comprises photosynthetic organisms. During photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is sequestered from the atmosphere while oxygen is released as a byproduct. The biosphere is a carbon dioxide sink and therefore an important part of the carbon cycle. So take note of this, the base of the food chain comprises photosynthetic organisms because these photosynthetic organisms are also called autotrophic organisms, wherein these are organisms that can manufacture their own food. So an example of this photosynthetic organism is the plant, wherein plants can manufacture their own food, and eventually that manufactured food will be used by the other organisms known as the heterotrophic organisms. And take note also that during photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is sequestered from the atmosphere, wherein yun yung gagamitin ng mga plants para makapag-manufacture sila ng own food. And in contrary, so magre-release naman sila ng oxygen, and this oxygen will be their byproduct, and itong byproduct na to will be used by humans and other organisms like animals. And we have here some of the examples showing the biosphere. So we have under the macroorganisms, we have the animals and also the plants. And under the microorganisms, we have the microbes and other minute organisms. So take note of this, bago ko makalimutan, diba, during this pandemic, diba, the reason why we are in this pandemic situation is because of the coronavirus. And coronavirus or viruses are not example of living organisms because they need a host in order for them to be alive. And ang mga living organisms, hindi nila kailangan ng host para sila ay mabuhay. While itong mga virus na to, kailangan nila ng host or someone or living organism para sila ay mabuhay. So take note of that. Virus is not an example of living organism. Alright, so as I've mentioned earlier, there are only four major types of the sphere of the Earth. Such as, first we have the hydrosphere, second is the geosphere, third is the atmosphere, and finally we have the biosphere. And right now, we're going to have an additional sphere of the Earth, which is known to be the cryosphere. So cryosphere is known as the frozen Earth. So under this, it is made up of ice, glaciers, and etc. So we have here the ice. Ay, iba yan. Ba't pa yan yung picture na lagi ko? Anyways, just kidding. So ice, we also have glaciers and icebergs. And also, na-mention natin kanina that the Earth is known to be a system. And we have here a picture showing the Earth as a system. So this is an example of why do we say that the Earth is a system. So ito is the eruption of the Mount Pinatubo in the year 1991. Kung tatanungin niyo yung mga parents nyo or yung mga kapatid nyo na buhay na, in this year 1991, sobrang naging malaking explosion to. Okay, and hindi lang Philippines ang naging apektado of this eruption of Mount Pinatubo, wherein halos buong mundo ay naapektuhan ng pagsabog ng Mount Pinatubo. And sabi natin kanina na whatever happens on a specific system of the Earth, maapektuhan din nun yung other system. And dito, alam natin that Mount Pinatubo is an example of geosphere, wherein itong geosphere na to, diba, nagbuga siya ng mga usok and other materials at the atmosphere, na apektuhan ngayon yung concentration of gases doon sa atmosphere. And eventually, kapag umulan, so pupunta yan ng hydrosphere at maapektuhan naman ngayon yung content or yung water content and concentration ng tubig. And also, pag may tumalsik din na other forms of earth or let's say material of earth sa tubig, so maapektuhan pa rin ngayon yung hydrosphere. And also, yung biosphere, marami ding namatay dito na mga hayop, plants, and also mga tao din, may mga namatay din dito. Okay, so definitely, naapektuhan din yung biosphere. And ganun yung pag sinabi natin na apektado ng isang sphere, ang isa pang sphere, at eventually yung iba pang sphere. So it's like a domino effect. And to further explain Earth as a system, so I have here a video presentation and you need to listen. You can also take down notes of the necessary information that you will hear on this video. So let us all listen and watch this.
Earth has four major geological subsystems. I will teach you in this song. I hope you learn and listen. Geosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere are four major systems on Earth that balance why we survive here. These systems are all separate but interact with one another in so many different ways. In each system you will discover. Let's start with geosphere, all Earth's materials and mass. It's comprised of all these parts that you'll be learning in my class. The solid live, and that's a fact. When volcanoes erupt, effect as the nuclei to help form water drops. That's the hydrosphere at work, and it never stops. When the rain falls to the earth, this is the hydrosphere, which stimulates plants to grow, which is the biosphere. The plants create oxygen that's released to the atmosphere. Plants also feed animals and humans, and that's biosphere. There's so many more examples you can find on your own. You can research them on your computer while sitting at home. Earth has four major geological subsystems. I will teach you in this song. I hope you learn and listen. Earth has four major geological subsystems. I will teach you in this song. I hope you learn and listen.
Okay, so that video actually summarizes the concept of the system. And right now, this is your turn. I know that some of you already answered some of the activities under this module. But right now, so kindly answer activity number 4, what's new now? And also activity 5, think, talk. And activity number 6, transfer it. And as a reminder again, so if there are things that are unclear to you, don't hesitate to contact me at any of these accounts. And also, so reminder ulit natin, no, whenever you eat or drink or do anything else, always do it to honor God from 1 Corinthians 10 verse 31. So that would be all. See you on our next video tutorial. God bless!